one in the world, and then one lost.
Yeah.
And they erased him off.
By the way, anything new for Ozecito? A lot of people wanted to know what's next for him.
Still waiting, but sure have something soon.
Ozecito, you see Virgil's fight?
Yeah.
What did you think?
Yeah, he looked good, man. Real good. Aggressive. Smart, aggressive.
What did you tell him in the corner between rounds? Because Maurice Hooker was game. Maurice Hooker was trying. He didn't run.
Nah,
he didn't box.
Nah, Maurice Hooker fucking game. He's got balls and he came to fucking fight. He didn't give a fuck. He was getting hit so hard and he was still fucking, you know, still.
He got rocked once he recovered.
Still fucking asking for more.
He has a good chin.
He's you know, he got my respect, honestly. Fucking dude. Plus he's a great dude. He's a great person. But you know, I noticed that Hooker was throwing his jab but dropping his hand. So I said, I was obviously, you know, trying to find that right hand. But after like three rounds, that's when I told Virgil, and you know, we told not only me, you know, Hector and his dad, Virgil Sr., let's go to the body. Boom, boom, and finish with body. So let's get the body. Let's work the body. And he did. You know, Virgil listens, and he broke him down with a lot of those body shots. Were the ones that started breaking him down and hurting him.
Terrence Crawford was there, Errol Spence was there.
Right.
What do you think they saw? They both said it was a great fight.
Look, they saw what everybody else seen. You know, Virgil is gonna be one of those young fighters that they're gonna have to, everybody's gonna have to have to know that whoever fights him is gonna have such a difficult time. Because that he's like a train coming to you with no fucking reverse and his strength, his power. So he doesn't have to be the most skillful fighter, you know, the most technical fighter. He does, you know, but those are the he'll give problems to any talented fighter. Look, I'm gonna give you an example. Maidana against Broner, Maidana against Mayweather, Margarito against Cotto. Brandon, you know, against
Alvarado.
Alvarado or the first one that was supposed to beat Brandon.
Antion?
No.
Oh, Anthony Peterson.
Anthony Peterson. You know, those are always gonna give you fucking problems. Especially if it goes to later rounds, you're in fucking trouble if you get tired, if you get cast out. Plus, I mentioned Brandon, Margarito, and Maidana. I think we're better than all three of those guys. Right, Pita? You don't think Virgil's better than all three?
They can, and who and who?
Brandon, Margarito, and Maidana.
Oh, yeah.
I think Virgil's is a lot better than those guys. So, the power, the condition, the strength, the will to win, they all have it. All three have it. All four have it. But I think Virgil's better than them. I think Virgil's much better than them. So that's another plus and another worry those guys have to have. Because anybody, as talented as you are, you're going to be in trouble with Virgil, because he could also take a punch. One thing that, if you guys go back, one thing that my dad told me right away when I went to visit him, he says, look, one thing that I noticed about Virgil is that he's blocking, he's got his hands up high and everything, but even if he gets hit, that doesn't worry him. He's not worried about getting hit. He's not worried about fuck, oh shit, what if I get hit too much? No. He doesn't, that don't fucking bother him at all. Brandon was the same way, Margarito was the same way, Maidana was the same way.
But a lot of fighters are worried.
No se preocupan cuando les pegan. Yeah, they
don't. But a lot of fighters are.
And we're just talking about that right now. It's fine with, we were talking with Lindolfo about it, that David Benavides, when he's here.
Yeah, same shit.
It's like, the guys here that we have, like Caballo, even for a 154, 1600, he hit fucking hard. Espino hits fucking hard, and David got hit a few times by the men. And it's like they don't even worry.
Like, for him, it's like, nah, fucking, like whatever. He keeps coming.
They know that they're gonna get hit, but they don't care.
See, that David is another one of those guys. David,
there's no reverse gear in their car.
Very talented.
David
has
to get worried.
David is talented. He's another one of those guys that when you go in there, you have to have the fucking best plan out there, the most condition to be able to hold that fucking train, you know, coming after you for 12 hard rounds. And Virgil's that kid too, with a lot of talent.
But Virgil with skill behind him.
With skills.
Virgil has a great fucking jab.
Good defense too.
Benavides.
You know,
I'm talking about like Margarito. Get out, Brandon.
Okay, Virgil's birthday is Thursday. What are you getting him for his birthday? He's gonna be 23.
Wish him a happy birthday.
Oh, no, I was gonna say we're gonna send him a girlfriend.
Okay.
I wish you had one. When is it, Thursday?